Yes, lad, what is going on?
My name is Amy O'Donoghue.
People call me Dr. Josh.
My name is Lewis O'Loughlin.
My name is Ulta Donald.
I'm Charlie O'Donovan.
I'm Abdul Jill.
I'm Scott Fagan.
I'm Mark Henry.
My name is Cormac Dalton.
I'm Paul Byrne.
I'm Mike Morgan.
More than a runner.
The Irish Hammer.
My name's Brennan.
I'm Brian Fay.
It's Dash Bar.
I am a triathlete.
Craig Engels.
Cheryl Nolan. Sean Dunham.
John Rankin.
I got 10th at the World Championships in 2019 in Doha.
I'm doing great. Just happy to be on the podcast.
I'm a Man United fan.
Let's get into this episode of the podcast. Yes, lads. What is going on? Welcome to Season 4, Episode 4 of The Running Irishman. I know in terms of posting a podcast, it's been about 3 weeks. I posted the vlog last week that... I have written down here as a topic kind of to touch on, which I'll jump into now, has been the support on that has been really, really great. Really happy you all enjoyed that episode, or sorry, that vlog. I put a lot of effort in, obviously recording that day. There was a lot of recording, there was a lot of footage that I did not put into that vlog, but in terms of the editing as well, I put a lot of editing in it. I was really pleased with how it came out, and overall I'm just really, really happy about the vlog, the support, the text I've been getting on Instagram, the views, everything. It's just been really, really amazing, and a lot more vlogs coming like that soon, because I am currently doing a bit of work with Athletics Ireland. Obviously the podcast really did help me get there. Obviously, if you haven't seen that vlog, I will link it down in the description below. But kind of what it was is the lads had their first round of the Dublin Championships that day, but I was also doing some interviews for Athletics Ireland. So, more vlogs will be coming like that, just because I will be doing more work with Athletics Ireland. I'm going to be doing interviews for them for the National Championships, Cross Country National Championships, and I'm going to work and do a bit more work interviewing with them for the European Championships, which is a huge experience for me, and I really am looking forward to that. So I do really want to thank Athletics Ireland for giving me the opportunity to do so, and as I mentioned, kind of have that experience under my belt, because obviously I want to take, you know, media, podcasting, commentary, this kind of whole area of stuff, like, kind of to a profession. So this experience will really stand with me, and I'm really appreciative for it. And as I mentioned, I wouldn't be able to do so without the help of the support of the podcast. So I do really appreciate you all that watch, listen, have subscribed, follow me on Instagram, anything. I do really, really appreciate it. So thank you very much for that. I kind of touched on there, kind of just working with Athletics Ireland. There's a bit of a backstory to it. I was out with my coach here watching the lads doing their Thursday long run, and we're just going along in the car. My coach follows him in the car up along the road, and my coach is like, well, why don't you get in touch with, you know, Athletics Ireland, send them an email to see if they've any work they can do for you. Literally what is happening, he kind of gave me the whole idea, my coach did. And I was like, geez, that's not a bad idea. He's like, just send them an email, say, give your podcast, you're interested in media, you want to do it after school, and it'd be good experience, just kind of chance your arm a little bit. And they got back, and they were up for it. It was initially just asking for like kind of like a media pass for the European Championships, but they end up giving me more experience, as I mentioned, the Autumn Open and National Championships leading up to that. So that's kind of the whole backstory about how it all came about. I'm also, for the national, for the European Championships, I'm also going to be working with my club to do like kind of a meet and greet in the airport. So I'm really looking forward to that. It's kind of like the athletes, when they land in the airport, there's going to be like a meet and greet section where, you know, athletes are like, people can come in, meet the athletes, talk to the athletes. I'm going to be kind of behind, not organizing, but helping out on that day in the airport. So I'm really looking forward to that. So a lot of things coming thick and fast. So that's kind of why I jumped on the podcast tonight. It is currently, you know, I'm live right now over on Twitch. It is currently 10:30 p.m. Here in Ireland. So It's definitely not an early one, but yeah, I just realised that, you know, I do have a bit to kind of talk about, and I feel like you guys are a podcast kind of because I haven't posted one in a while, so there are kind of just two things I want to touch on, as mentioned. I also want to do a commentary course with Athletics Ireland, so that's not a definite thing yet. I was just scrolling through the website one of the days, and I saw that there was they were doing a commentary course, so you had to apply, and you had to fill out a form, and you also had to send a 3-minute maximum clip of you commentating over an event of your choice. I'd done the last two laps of the Tokyo 5000 meter final, which I was pretty proud of how it came out. I haven't heard anything back. It is next Wednesday, so fingers crossed I get that opportunity. I was in touch with head lad over at media in Athletics Ireland, and he said he'd put my name down for it, so fingers crossed I do get in there. At the moment as well, I am looking for a job. I'm in sixth year and I kind of want a bit of work at the weekend. This is kind of just an overview of things that have been happening in my life before we kind of get into the meaty stuff in terms of my injury and whatnot, because I'm sure that's why a lot of you are here. So I am looking for a job. I have handed in CVs all over the place, and I haven't had too much success, but it's kind of like I'm going on a holiday next year with my mates, and I kind of just want to have a bit of money. Yes, lads, so this is me after the entire episode of the podcast being recorded. I'm going to really quick insert the commentary video right here that I recorded for the commentary workshop for Athletics Ireland. So if you are watching it, obviously you will see the whole thing. If you're listening to this episode of the podcast, obviously you're going to hear it perfectly, no problem. If you want to see exactly what I'm commentating over, there will be a link to the YouTube channel in the show notes below. So I just wanted to give you a heads up why, you know, there's just me randomly starting to commentate over the Tokyo 5000 meter final. This is why I just decided to insert it here now. So yeah, I hope you all enjoy it. Coming into the final straight now with just over 800 meters to go, we still have a huge group of athletes there, a group of 10 athletes with some really, really big names like Paul Chelimo, Jacob Kiplimo, you can see there, Joshua Cheptegei, the world record holder, and it's anyone's race at the moment. You can see Grant Fisher from the USA at the back of that group trying to hold on just for as long as he can. We can see Kameli there from Kenya leading us out into the back straight. And we still have a really, really tightly packed bunch here. You can see Getir from Spain and Justin Knight from Canada. Knight looking really, really smooth. Still, as I said, a tightly packed bunch. And Chelimo's falling into the inside rail. That could be costly for him in terms of disqualification. But he still has to just try and stay focused on either getting that top 1, 2, or 3 position. You can see now Joshua Cheptegei has taken the lead. Coming in to the final straight for the penultimate time. Will someone kick at the bell? We'll just have to wait and see. Still quite a tightly packed bunch. We can see Grant Fisher at the back there falling off the pace, as well as Getir from Spain is starting to look like he's struggling a bit. Grimacing of the teeth. We're just going to have to wait and see at the bell. Is anyone going to kick? We can see the pack is starting to string out already. And Joshua Cheptegei has put in a surge. We can see Kameli there from Kenya trying to hang on to him, trying to take the lead. And we see Paul Chelimo covering that move, as well as Kiplimo and the two athletes at the back of that group. Still anyone's race from this pack of six, and we're coming in now to the back straight for the final time. It's guns to the wall. Everyone is going as fast as they can. You can see Kiplimo there trying to reattach himself to that front three. Joshua Cheptegei still in the lead. Kameli there really, really working hard to get second place. It looks like Joshua Cheptegei is starting to form a little bit of a gap here coming into the final straight for the very last time. But positioned for second and third place, the war is still happening on all behind Joshua Cheptegei. You can see Chelimo there and Ahmed Mohamed really, really battling it out. Well, it looks like Mohamed is getting away. It is all about Joshua Cheptegei coming in first. It is Mohamed of Canada coming in second. And Paul Chelimo dives over the line to claim third place. What a race. So now we're going back into the podcast. Just to refresh you, I was talking about why I wanted a job and to get a bit of money to go away with my friends next year. And then we're going to get into the good stuff in this episode, talking more about my physio, my recovery, my injury, and actually I started back a little bit of running. So yeah, that was just a bit of a refresher after that 2-minute period of the commentary. for myself spending money to have when I go away with my mates next year. We have that booked and everything, so obviously really looking forward to going to Portugal. So yeah, I'm looking for a job. Obviously I have to work with Athletics Ireland, but that obviously is, it's just experience, and it's not just experience, I really do I'm enjoying it and I do appreciate it. But yeah, in terms of kind of being employed as such, I am kind of looking for that at the moment. So yeah, kind of looking for a job, commentary course, working with Lex on the vlog, kind of all them kind of key little points that I wanted to touch on before I got into kind of into the meaty stuff of this episode. So I am running again, kind of, not really, a little bit. So I kind of go back to the last time from when we recorded an episode. So that was about, in terms of like the update episode, it was like 2 episodes ago, because the gaps have been quite big, because of school and stuff. But back then, and in the vlog as well, sorry, kind of backtracking a bit, in the vlog you saw my, you saw kind of the routine I had in terms of my exercises for then, and I mentioned in the vlog that it was kind of up in the air, not up in the air, but kind of my exercises are kind of always changing. And most time I go back to the physio, I get an exercise added on, a new exercise, an exercise taken off, so it is always different in terms of my exercises now. Like compared to what was in the vlog, I'm still doing the lunges. I'm not doing the resistant band, like where you kind of lie down and you open your legs up and down, and I'm not doing the stand on one leg. I'm doing the lunges. I'm still stretching out my Achilles, still stretching out my calves. I'm back doing calf raises on the step, and I am now doing this exercise where you kind of put your leg over, so you put a foam roller underneath the back of your knee, and then turn your foot to like a 30 degree angle, and then you kind of keep straightening out your knee and straightening out your knee. I do that 10 times for 3 sets on each leg. That is to strengthen the muscles on the inside of my leg. So that's currently the exercises that I am doing now. So in terms of progress, with my Achilles, they haven't flared up in a while since the last time I was back in the physio. We've done a really good stretch out that day, and I have been stretching them. Before the physio, they were still slightly flaring up every now and then. But they are definitely getting a lot better in terms of, you know, when I wake up in the morning, they're not like really, really stiff. They don't always flare up when I kind of move every now and then, where they usually always would. This is kind of like just an overview until we get into the actual kind of running bit of it. With my knees, they're grand. They're still kind of the same. They're a little bit better. Like with my knees, it's really, really on and off. They can be really good, then they can be okay. They're never usually too bad. Like my Achilles can get really bad. But yeah, kind of going back to then, last week in the physio, I actually ran on the treadmill. So as I mentioned, we done a really big stretch out on the Achilles before we start running on the treadmill. I done 5 minutes, and he kept ramping up the pace, and he started ramping up the incline gradually. Done that for 5 minutes, seeing how my body reacted. So my Achilles didn't flare up at all. Afterwards though, during the course of that day, my knees were quite sore and they were quite tender when I walked on them. But overall they weren't too bad. So my physio then decided to get me back running, but like it wasn't to get back running to get fit. It was kind of just to get back running to see how my body would react. So what the plan is now in terms of my running is every second to third day, I do 5 minute walk, 10 minute jog, 5 minute walk, 5 minute jog. As I mentioned, it's not to get back fit. It's primarily just to see how my body's been reacting. And that's kind of what I want to get into now. So I've kind of gone over, you know, where my stretches were, where I was at, in terms of the pain and stuff. So the pain is, it's still there, definitely, but it's less frequent. I wouldn't say it's less prominent, as such, because when it is there, it's just as prominent, but the pain that is prominent isn't as frequent, if that makes sense, if you know what I'm trying to say there. So in terms of how I feel during and after the run, so before I stretch out my Achilles, I stretch out my calves, really, you know, do try and kind of give myself the benefit of the doubt, as I would if I was going for any run. And probably from now on, I will probably continue to stretch out my Achilles before I go run when I'm back 100%, just so it doesn't take too long to do. It's only a minute or so, and it will just kind of give me that certainty in my head that, you know, like, I have stretched them out, they shouldn't flare up, and then I'll be confident and ready to go. So I will probably continue to do that, even when I'm back running 100%. So during it, as I mentioned, when I stretch out my calves, stretch out my Achilles and stuff, I feel grand. And then during it, over the past four times I've ran, so including the time in the physio, and then the three other times that I ran yesterday, which is Friday. I'm gonna run tomorrow, which is Sunday. And I ran Tuesday, so that's the physio Tuesday, Friday, and I'm gonna run tomorrow. So that's four times, out of the three times that I've done it so far, my Achilles have not flared up at all. They haven't flared up at all during it. In terms of my knees during the running, they haven't been sore during the running at all. Maybe yesterday I could slightly feel my right one, but it wasn't too bad whatsoever. I've been doing it all on the grass, except for that one time in the physio we're done it on the treadmill. But every time before that, I'd done it on the grass. Just, you know, soft surface, low impact, kind of protecting my joints as much as I possibly can. The Tuesday when I'd done it with the team in Trinity, because they had races last Sunday, which were in Trinity, which you done really well. All the teams qualified for the Nationals. We got a third place, we got a few fourth places, we got a first place, we won the national, the senior Dublin Championships, we got first place as a team and first place individual with the senior. So really, really great day out in the uneven age Dublin Championships last week. So on that Tuesday, then the team done a kind of just slow, easy run on the grass in Trinity. So while they done that, I done my little bit of physio running as well. which during that one, my knees were perfect. My Achilles weren't sore. I could feel they were just a tiny bit tight. Now that could have been the cold as well. But yeah, they were a tiny bit tight as well. Could have been the cold, but felt pretty good. And during that, I went really, really slow. And then yesterday, I went a little bit faster. That's maybe why it was a little bit of a shock to the knees. Today, after doing the run yesterday, my knees feel... I can definitely feel them. This morning, getting up, my Achilles were a little bit tight. They haven't flared up at all today, which is the most important thing. And that was the thing my physio was basically saying, that, like, if you're during the course day, I was like, right, just say I'm in school and my Achilles flare up once or twice during the course of the day, will I still go out and do the runs? And because he was saying, I'm not doing the runs to get back fit, I'm just doing the runs to see how my body reacts, he was saying, no, don't go out the run. Obviously, you're not back running yet. It's, as Keith mentioned, it's just to see how you react. So he's just like, yeah, don't do it that day. And then maybe the next day, if your Achilles don't flare up, then do it that day. And my Achilles haven't flared up since I've been at the physio last Saturday, which is good. The thing about it is, and this is the thing I said to my physio, is that I'm really not expecting them to flare up when I'm running. I'm expecting my knees to hurt when I'm running a little bit, and I'm expecting my knees to hurt a little bit after it. But it's the things where, like, if I stretch them out and then go running and the blood's flowing and everything's moving, I'm not expecting them to flare up, to be honest with you. But it's kind of just when I'm doing other things where it's like, you know, walking and, you know, walking down the road, crossing over the lights, just say, for example, and the lights are turning red and I couldn't just do a little jog across the road. Or, for example, the other day I was out with my mates, the dart came along and we were contemplating whether this is the one we had to get on and off. So we were sitting there and the doors were just about to close and I'd done a little bit of a jog over it. It wasn't even a jog, it was just like two big steps, like two kind of long strides. And my Achilles flared up. So it's kind of them situations where I expect them to flare up and they do flare up. And that's the situations where I don't want them to flare up. So yeah, it's kind of things like that. I don't expect them to flare up while I'm running. Maybe when I'm back on the track in my spikes. Or maybe when I'm back in my spikes on the cross country doing a fast stride, they might flare up. But when I'm doing a little bit of a jog on the grass, I'm really not expecting them to flare up. And, you know, it's all well and good being healthy for running, but realistically, you know, I want to be healthy in my every day-to-day life. So, yeah, since I've been to the physio last Saturday, they haven't flared up, even just in day-to-day life, excluding running, which has been really, really good. My knees after Tuesday were perfect because I went really, really slow on the grass. As I mentioned today, I can slightly feel my knees a little bit more, and what else, my Achilles were a little bit tight this morning, but you know, that's again is just because I went a little bit faster, and I haven't ran in a while on the injuries, so my legs are going to react a little bit with a little bit of soreness, so I'm not too worried about that at all. So yeah, that's kind of my running bit, you know. The lads have a 2 mile run tomorrow, kind of like it's not a race, it's more of a park run. It's not by Park Run Ireland or anything, but it is more of a park run. So what I'm going to do is, you know, before that, I'm going to go out and I'm going to go out to where the run is, and I'm going to do my own little bit of a run that my physio gave me, and then I'm going to watch that. So yeah, that's the plan for tomorrow. I'm kind of just happy that I'm back running, you know. This obviously isn't going to be the longest episode. I am planning on getting more episodes with guests out, obviously still with 6 year and stuff. It is a little bit difficult because, you know, priorities are kind of all up in the air at the moment. But I am quite happy that I'm recording this episode and I'm going to get this episode out. And I did kind of fly through the first few bits about the vlog and working with athletics Ireland and the looking for a job and a commentary course and whatnot. But I did kind of want to just get into this kind of, you know, meatier stuff in terms of the running. And kind of the last thing that, you know, I wanted to kind of just touch on was that our team could possibly be splitting up after Christmas. So not splitting up, it'd be just kind of moving on coaches as you get up the age, as kind of you do in any sport. So that's not 100% yet. We thought it would be after this cross country season and after the track season, so basically when the running year ends. But it was kind of not rumored, but it's looking like we will be splitting up, not splitting up after Christmas, kind of moving on from the coach, which is a little bit upsetting if it does go ahead, because obviously we're a really, really great team at the moment. Some of the younger lads will be staying with the coach that we're currently with now. So I kind of thought that would just be something important that I would touch on. As I mentioned, it's not 100% yet. I will be keeping you all up to date on that. But yeah, it is kind of something to kind of be keeping our eyes on. And obviously the team that we have now is really, really great. And, you know, if I could, I'd probably stay with this team for forever. But obviously that's not how things work. Yeah, I am really, really looking forward to getting back out and doing a little bit of a run tomorrow. As I mentioned, it's a 5 minute walk, 5 minute jog, 10 minute walk. Or 5 minute walk, 10 minute jog, 5 minute walk, 5 minute jog. I really do enjoy it. And I'm back in the physio next Saturday. I think he'll probably get me on the treadmill again. Kind of just to see how my body reacts compared to, well, when the physio comes around next week, it'll be 2 weeks ago. And to see if my fitness has gone up at all. In just, you know, naturally it would go up if I'm doing more running than I have been prior to the last physio session. So kind of and just to see where we're at in terms of pain and stuff in the body. And we are on the right track in terms of getting back to running. We're on the right track in terms of getting back. That rhymes. But yeah, we are on the right track. We're getting there. You know, as I mentioned, there's other things outside of running. There's working with athletics Ireland. There's doing help my coach a bit of coaching. There's school. There's the commentary course. There's looking for a job. There's the podcast. There's everything. There's a lot more outside of running. There isn't just running. And I know a lot of the stuff I said there links with running, but in terms of physically running, there is a lot more outside of that. So I do need to keep that in mind. You know, running is a big part of my life, and in terms of I do it every day, and you know, I made loads of friends through running, and my podcast is around running and stuff. But you don't need to be doing running to be able to talk about or to be able to know about it. So as much as I'm really looking forward to hopefully be getting back running, there is a lot more things I can do, and not just kind of sitting around feeling sorry for myself, dwelling on the situation. Like, I don't know if being able to get these Athletics Ireland experiences, actually, in saying that, I would not be working with Athletics Ireland if I didn't get injured, because I would not have been sitting in that car with my coach watching the lads doing the long run, and he wouldn't have said it on to me because I would have been out doing the long run. So things like that vlog, that there wouldn't have been that vlog because I would have been racing. There wouldn't be me doing them interviews for Athletics Ireland for the Autumn Open that day because I'd have been racing, because I wouldn't been in the car with my coach that day where he gave me the idea. I would have been out doing a long run. I wouldn't be doing interviews for the National Senior Championships. I wouldn't be getting the opportunity to possibly interview Jakob Ingebrigtsen, the 1500 meter Olympic champion in 2021 Olympics. You know, there's always, you know, kind of a silver lining as such. So, yeah, as much as I would love to be running right now, there's a lot of other things that probably do have a bigger effect on my life in terms of my future, that I wouldn't be doing right now if I didn't get injured. So, kind of just, you can look on the bright side like that, and it will definitely help you get through the situation. So, yeah, look, as much as I am looking forward to getting back to running and getting back with the team and kind of having more of a routine, because usually I'd come home from school, I'd do my run, and I'm like, right, I have my run done, I can get down to study. But then sometimes I come home from school and I sit around and I do nothing for maybe 45 minutes, and I'm like dragging myself to do a bit of homework and dragging myself to do a bit of studying. So having the kind of that routine in your life, I'm definitely looking forward to having that back now. I'm not saying that I'm anywhere near that right now, but is a step in the right direction. I have been talking to my coach and stuff about it, and he's been saying it's a slong. It's a long, slow process. But look, I just need to keep focusing on things like the podcast, like the work with Athletics Ireland, like the Leaving Cert, like trying to find a job, and you know, doing all the recovery and rehab stuff in the background, and eventually I will be back. Actually, one last thing I do want to touch on is, if you remember kind of in the first episode when I was talking about my injury, I was saying that, like, we're not too sure what it is, whether it's ligaments. Remember, I was talking about ligaments a lot, in terms of the inside of my knees. It was because of the arch of my foot and everything. Well, it's not. It is growing pains. Finally, I'm growing. It is definitely growing pains because, one, as I've stretched, so we were loading onto my Achilles, and said we should have been stretching them. So it was kind of all the everything around, just say my ankle, like the bone, all the other muscles, all the other ligaments were growing. But obviously my Achilles wasn't growing quick enough, so I had to stretch that out, and that sped up the process of the Achilles pain going away. It was specifically in my Achilles anyway, that was growing pain. So we kind of stopped loading onto that for a while, and we started stretching it, and that has really, really helped. Also, when I first at the physio, a month ago, I was at the physio. I measured my height and I was 5'7", and then I started stretching my Achilles, stretching my calves, to obviously help with the Achilles pain. And then I'm now 5'8", so it is ground pains, and as well in my knees it is ground pains. So I did kind of just want to clear that up a little bit, and say that's actually where the injuries come from. So I need to do my physio exercises, let the ground pains run their course, let the ground kind of run its course a little bit, and as I mentioned, kind of keep doing, you know, the podcast, the vlogs, working with lecture and leaving, so looking for a job, kind of all doing that at the forefront, and kind of the running and recovery stuff in the background. I just wanted to jump on. I know it's a late one tonight, in terms of going live, but this episode obviously will be going out on Sunday. It will be going out tomorrow, fingers crossed, everything going well. I did want to just jump on, kind of go through all these little points, and I know it's not the longest episode of the podcast in the world, but I just kind of wanted to give a little bit of an update. That's going to be it for tonight. I hope you all enjoyed, and I'll see you all next time. Bye.